Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you stop living in chaos, one organizing project at a time.
In this video, I'm going to show you how to organize a blackout box.
You will need some type of container. I chose this bin that's pretty sturdy. I got this from Staples. I'll put a link if I can find it on the website or on the Amazon website. And you preferably want something that has a cover. I like covers that go like this, or lids that go like this, versus the ones that just latch on. I just find that they hold better.
Then you will label it. I just chose to use my label maker. I have a label here and on the other side, because however you put it on the shelf, you could see a label if it's facing out this way, or you could see the label if it's facing out this way. When you open it up, this is how my blackout box looks like. You can also call it a power outage box. Anything that you need when the power goes out, you will put it in this box, so that in one place, in your garage or wherever you want to put this in your house or your apartment, you can go here and everything here that you need for a power outage is right at your fingertips. The first thing you will need in a blackout box or a power outage kit are lights. So here you can always go to the camping section of any website or a store and find really affordable camping lights. Like these use D batteries. Okay. And I like to keep it in its original box because it just holds the shape better. If you need to take it out of the box because you need space, go right ahead. And then here I have some more camping lanterns. Again, I kept it in the box and I've just used my label maker to label it because, of course, I would know what's in this box. My family doesn't necessarily know everything is in this box. I will brief them one or two times, but they're probably not going to remember. So that's why I use labels in many places. And by the way, these camping lanterns are really one of my favorites. I've gone through so many camping lanterns and this just happens to be the logo on it, but there's a whole bunch on Amazon. And the wonderful thing is you can control the amount of light that you want. So let's say you just want some ambient lighting, or you want to use this and walk around the house to get whatever you need, then you can put it fully up or you can adjust and then it just closes like that and turns off that way. The battery is over here and you just unscrew it like this. Very easy. It uses three AA batteries. And I just had to mention this one because I really like this the last time we went camping. So they come in a box of two. I also chose to keep the bubble wrap that it comes with because if for some reason the box gets destroyed or whatever gets wet, I can still have this as protection for the lanterns. Here's the last lantern. I've had this for, I think, 15 years. Still works. D batteries, you can put it on one or two, off. And it has a convenient handle. So when I look for lanterns, of course, most of them have handles. Just make sure it has. So you can see one light, two lights, and then it kind of opens in different configurations if you want it standing up like that. Over here, I have a heavy duty flashlight. This was from Costco, and I believe it uses AA batteries, like a whole bunch of them, maybe 12 or 13. And the nice thing here is that you can focus it. So this, when you pull it out like that, the light focuses. And when you pull it back, the light kind of opens up more to give you more square footage of what you're looking at. And then it turns on with this. Look at this, how bright it is. Okay, so here I'm gonna try to see the focus. Isn't that cool? And then it goes out. And the nice thing with this too is that it can actually be a weapon if you need it. Boing! I suppose boing is maybe the head is bouncy, but actually boink. The next thing you'll need is a hand crank weather radio. So here I just got this from Amazon. The brand is Foss Power. I have a
a phone battery charger from the same company, Foss Power, and I absolutely love it. So I had to check if they had something like this first. So that's the company I use. It has a carabiner and a strap, of course, that you can put around your wrist. And then AM, FM, and weather radio. Here you can use the battery or you can use the solar power. Here you switch it here, AAA. And then the other power, hand crank. Okay, and this is the cool thing. See, this is where the solar power is. You open this up. Ta-da! I love little things like this. Here it also has a flashlight. Ah! Okay, so here you can have it where it's charging your phone. And here's an SOS signal. I'm not gonna turn it on because it's loud, unless you wanna hear it. Do you wanna hear it? Yes or no? Yes, okay. Get ready. Oh, okay. All right, and then you can also charge your cell phone. So here, you see the plug there for your phone or another type of plug. And yes, it has an antenna. Okay. All right. I love how it goes back in. Love stuff like that. Okay, so a hand crank weather radio. Then you will need containers for extra batteries and different things. The other nice thing about this bin is that you can use this as a small tabletop. I got this container from the Dollar Tree. So this is a dollar. It latches on pretty decently. Again, I use my label maker to make labels. So you want to have the same number of batteries, or at least enough to replenish if the batteries need to be replaced while you're in the middle of the power outage. So I have here AAA batteries, AA batteries, and also here D batteries. Okay, I have battery operated tea lights, and I do need to get batteries for those, so I'll probably stick them in here somewhere, like there. And here is the USB cord for your phone. You may want to put the one that you have just to make sure it fits into your phone. And then I got this from the Dollar Tree. It's a small utility knife thing, and I actually got it for just the can opener part, so I figured I might need an extra can opener. And then this is from Walmart. They are stormproof matches, always good to have those. And that is the little container from the Dollar Tree. Very easy to organize. Now let's move on to this one. I absolutely love this bag. And I tell you, they sell this at the Container Store. It is much cheaper on Amazon, probably half the price. So people, go on Amazon. There are different sizes. I'll put the link to all these products in the description box below. But it's called a mesh envelope. Okay, so a mesh vinyl envelope. And you can see here, there's a nice zipper that you can grab. Okay, I don't like those little tiny things that you have to grab. So this is nice, opens well. And you can see here, if you touch it, there is a mesh. And the nice thing is it's supposed to be puncture resistant and waterproof, right? Or at least water resistant. And then I just have the D batteries in here, enough to replace the ones that the camping lanterns that use the D batteries. And so just lay it flat, zip it, and then just kind of fold it like that. See how nicely these fit into the box. So I just want to make sure that this label is facing up. So now I'm going to show you what's in these mesh envelopes. There is one for each member of my family, my husband, me, and my two kids. Okay, again, I've used my label maker. I put my name, and then I put in parentheses everything that's in this bag. The reason I do that is for myself. Instead of using my brain energy to try to remember what to put in here if it needs to be replenished, it's just listed out for me. And when my family members get their bag, they will know what's in the bag. Okay, so I have headlamp, a fan, cooling towel, water, a Mylar blanket, hand and toe warmers, a flashlight, and reusable glow stick. Some of these things you can get at the Dollar Tree. Of course, you can get it from Amazon. And so the first thing I have is a headlamp. So when you're walking around the house, if you want to have both hands free, instead of holding the camping lantern or a flashlight, you can have this on your head. If you've ever gone camping, you know how this is like one of the main essentials when you go camping. So if you need it for camping, for walking in the dark, you will need it for walking around the dark in your house. Okay, the next thing I have is this fan. It's a battery operated fan, personal fan. You could put it around your neck. Okay, there are different types. I chose this one. I don't like the string. I wish more that it was more of a, you know, like more of a thicker strap. I don't know how long this will last as far as comfort around your neck. It does use AA batteries, I believe. Yes, two AA batteries. And then there's just an off and on. When you put it around your neck, make sure this is facing forward, and then the air comes up here to your neck. So I use this, walked around the house with it. It is a nice flow, especially if you live in a warmer place. If you had a power outage when it's this hot summer months, like here in Arizona, it gets to around 110, 112, sometimes a little bit more than that during the middle of July. And we've had a power outage for 4 hours one time in the middle of July. It was not good. Luckily, my husband's office was near enough. We went there for those few hours and then were able to come back. But if it was more prolonged and, you know, a larger area was out of electricity, then you have to prepare for yourself and for your family. Okay, the other thing I have is a bottle of water. So I have a water, emergency water supply. We have a Life Straw, we have a water bob. So I'm working towards more water storage, but I decided to go ahead and put water in here just so, you know, a quick relief if we need to drink water. And of course, I go through these things every few months just to replenish and make sure things are up to date. The other reason why I have water is because I have here a cooling towel. These are amazing. It was like a lifesaver. We were in Tokyo, Japan, Manila, Philippines for 3 weeks, one time in the middle of July. It was so hot. And when you're not used to humidity, because you've been living in Arizona, dry heat for like forever, it was just not good. Okay, but you just dampen the cooling towel. And that's why I have water here, just in case, you know, so for whatever reason, the water has stopped. And you can wrap that around your neck, put it on top of your head. It is such a great invention. Okay, next thing I have is a Mylar blanket. I got these from Walmart. I think sometimes they might have it at the Dollar Tree. Again, if you're in colder weather, now our weather gets down to maybe 40 at one time. A few times it might be freezing at 32 degrees Fahrenheit. But if the heat is out, because for whatever reason, our house is heated by gas. So again, power outage is not just electricity, just power is out where you're, you know, things like the gas is out, the electric stove is out. This is what you want to prep for. So we have Mylar blankets. Of course you have blankets, okay? But that's just added. And then here we have toe and hand warmers. I know I grew up in the Chicago area. It's freezing. And you know, it gets cold quickly in your house when the heat is off. And then I also have this reusable glow stick. This was fun. I mean, at first I wasn't planning on having this, but I saw this at Costco. It has a strap, okay? And each bag, each member of the family has one. Again, a little flashlight, a blinking glow stick. This might be nice if you need to call attention to yourself. And then there's the one that just stays on. And then at the end, this is nice. There's a whistle, okay? So it's nice to have a cap. Each person has their own because you don't want to cross-contaminate. And you can blow the whistle for help. Of course, you can put these in a Ziploc bag or any type of bag. I just like this, again, because they're just more reinforced and you can kind of see through them. So look how nicely these fit back into the bin. So I just put it in order of my husband, me, my older kid, my younger kid. Now I'm going to show you what are in these two bags. Same envelope, use the label maker, glow sticks, tea light candles, fire start lighter, body wipes, notebook, and pen. Okay, body wipes if you want to clean up. Glow sticks, these are 3-in-1 from the Dollar Tree, so I got 4 of them. Okay, it might be something like you want to break them and put them around the table, around the house, by the stairs. Okay, fire start, this is from Walmart. You don't have to get this, you can always make your own. Tea light candles, so I got these in case the battery operated tea lights don't work. I can always light these up. And as much as possible, I want to use battery operated. I don't like open flames around the house. And then I also have a lighter. I think I got this from the Dollar Tree. And this is also from the Dollar Tree. Just a notebook and pen to write. If for some reason your phone is not working, you want to jot some notes, play some games, you can do that. Okay, and then when I put stuff back into the bag, this is not essential, but just wanted to show you what I do. I like to make the bag as flat as possible, so I just don't throw everything in. It's kind of like Tetris. I love Tetris, and I know why, okay? And so you just try to fit in things to create that flatness when the bag is either standing up or laying down. So I have the tea light candles there. This, the fire start is over here. Okay, the lighter fits kind of on top there. And then you have there. So you see how it's pretty flat. And you mustn't forget games. Games and cards. It's a great time to play cards when there's a power outage. So I have Uno. I also have a whole thing of Sudoku. Yes. You have younger kids, you can get more of these smaller types of games. Like a Barrel of Monkeys, a good old classic. Then you always want a deck of cards. I just switched out the rubber band. I forgot that I usually do this. I put hair bands around something that I need a rubber band for, because you can always use this and tie up your hair. Then I have this Sushi Go game. Okay. If you go to Target, Walmart, or any type of big stores like that, they have travel size games that would be perfect for your blackout box. Again, I arrange them in the bag to be as flat as possible. Okay, I even put this Barrel of Monkeys in the middle, because when I put it on the side, it didn't lay as flat. So now you see how they fit perfectly in this space. So when I was putting this box together, okay, it wasn't like one time I put them in and it fit like this. I had to do Tetris, okay? Put your jigsaw puzzle together. And it usually works out, you know? It may not be perfect, but it works out pretty well. Enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments below what you would put in your blackout box or what you have in your blackout box. You can see how simple it is to put together. It's things that you will need, and you're going to be happy that you have this when that unfortunate event of a power outage occurs. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Is the clutter in your home leaving you exhausted? I can help you stop living in chaos. Go to my website and schedule a free 20-minute virtual home organizing assessment, simplysherry.com. Click the pink button, Get Organized Today. It'll bring you to a page for Calendly. Choose the time that works for you, and you will receive an email with a Zoom call link. I look forward to helping you. All this time you've-